Saturday Fight Night, live tonight from Nottingham, where boxing is buzzing again. And they're out in force here tonight for the city's best-known double act. Jason Booth thrilled his hometown crowd time and again, and Nottingham's brought out the best in him. But the best might be needed against Lunga and Ntontela of South Africa. Nicky Booth seen off some of the best of Britain's bantamweights here, but he's in international class tonight, as Nathan Sting comes from Australia trying to extend his winning run in Britain. Yes, it's the Booth brothers side by side live on Saturday Fight Night. This is where they've served up most of their most memorable shows at home in Nottingham. Jason now stepping up 3 pounds to super flyweight to challenge for Ntontela's international belt. And at bantamweight, Nicky takes on Nathan Sting for the Australian's new title. The battling Booth brothers. Nicky reckons he's the one with all the charisma. First round to him then. But they are a double act to rival the old boxing family firms like the McKenzies, Finnegans and Feeneys. Both smooth when they want to be though. We've enjoyed the routine so far. There have been a couple of nights when they've fallen a little flat though. Now's a great time to polish up the partnership. Well, in domestic terms, there's no doubt that this has been a double act full of success so far and how the Booths have profited. But they know that they want to make their mark on the international scene, and they've really got to start to put that right here tonight. Spencer Oliver has witnessed many of their better nights here in Nottingham. Also tonight, another Nottingham fighter who served up some thrillers in front of his hometown crowd. Welterweight Jawade Khalik still just about claiming position as Britain's number one, defending his title in a rematch with Maxim Nesterenko. You may remember him, the Russian who pushed him so close in their first meeting 18 months ago. News of that rematch coming a little bit later on. But it is the Booth brothers who are the top draw here in Nottingham tonight. Craig Slater looking ahead not once, but twice. Better smile.
They're boxing's comedy double act, but Jason and Nicky Booth get serious tonight as they seek a springboard onto the world stage.
Tonight's the night the Booth brothers step up to the highest level.
A pro at 18, Jason's career had a lightning start.
Jason Booth is the British and Commonwealth flyweight champion.
But European title defeats and a street attack in Nottingham city centre checked his progress. Now he's back, hungrier than ever.
I've got my own confidence. I think me as didn't want anyone out there. When I'm on the head of my game and I'm doing what I should be doing in the ring, no one will beat me.
And the rugged box fighters ready to make a statement against unbeaten South African Lunga Mad Dog Ntontela.
I know he's good. He ain't had a lot of fights, but the people on his record, and he's from South Africa, and he's well respected over there.
I'm gonna come mad to Jason Paul. I'm Mad Dog. So I'm fighting like a mad dog, you know, I'm a mad dog.
Like Jason, Nicky's been a long reigning British champion.
Nicky Booth, what a performance.
But he has been exposed by top class southpaws Jose Sanjuanelo and Steve Molitor.
If you don't meet him, you don't beat him, and I want to meet him all and beat him all, and after this one, move on to something bigger, better, and bring him all back to my hometown.
And in Nathan Sting, he faces an Australian left-hander who's come to Britain and won before.
I'm just going to box him the same way I boxed Johnny Armour. Blokes that come to me, they're made for me.
Every round, every minute, every second, he's going to feel pure, unadulterated pain.
Display of non-stop punching and aggression.
But the Booths say they're invincible on home turf and believe the Nottingham factor will again prove crucial.
I've never been beaten, Nottingham, and it sure ain't going to happen tonight.
Yes, the entertainment value's been very high, Spencer, but we're not being kidded by that, are we? There is still another level for them to reach out for here.
Well, there is another level, and I mean, Nicky Booth, we've seen him when he's moved up into the international level and he's fallen short against Sanjuanelo and Jason as well. Three European title shots away from home, but he's got a home advantage this evening, so maybe he can turn it around. But international level still remains to be seen.
It'll be Nicky first up here tonight, and he's up against Nathan Sting, a man returning to our shores after a convincing victory in the summer against Johnny Armour. How impressed were you with Sting that night?
Well, Nathan Sting, I remember watching him box against Paul Lloyd and getting beaten against Paul Lloyd, but come on immensely when we see him against Johnny Armour, and really done a real job on Johnny Armour. It was really a shutout, convincing win.
Spencer, he's almost a veteran now at the age of 30, Sting, but is he actually getting better at this stage?
Well, that's what I said. I've seen him against Paul Lloyd, and Paul Lloyd really destroyed him, but when I saw him, it was like seeing a totally different fighter. He was very fluent, switching orthodox to southpaw, and really took Johnny Armour apart. So, and Nicky's got a real difficult job here.
You mentioned the bogey word, southpaw, and it's against the southpaws that Nicky's had all the problems through his career, isn't it?
Yeah, we see him against Steve Molitor of Canada. He fell short. He was a southpaw, and Sam Wanao really took him apart. He was a southpaw as well, and unfortunately for him here, we've seen him against another southpaw.
What are the lessons that Nicky can learn from this display?
Well, Nicky's just got to learn not to get involved. That's Nicky's big problem. He gets involved too much. He's got beautiful boxing skills and box on the outside, but he does get drawn into a fight.
It's remarkable. He's packed a lot into his short career. Just 23 years of age, Nicky. Done so well. And let's remember, he is still the reigning British bantamweight champion. But we're here, as we say tonight, to see how much higher he can reach. All is set here in Nottingham. He's on his way out. Our commentary team at ringside tonight will be Ian Dark and Glenn McCrory, and our master of ceremonies is John MacDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's championship boxing. Please welcome to the ring now, from Nottingham, once more, Nicky.
Well, I think this is a fascinating fight that we have here in Nottingham tonight. Lovely clash of styles between Nicky Booth and Nathan Sting. Here is Booth from Nottingham, who's been in some real value for money fights in his career, Glenn, hasn't he?
Yes, he has some very good fights. He's got a great work rate, and he really brings a lot of intensity into the ring. He's a character, very, very confident, and you know, he really likes boxing in front of his home crowd in Nottingham.
Yep, you can see he enjoys the stage. But he might find this Nathan Sting quite a slippery character. He likes a row in there, Nicky Booth, in really memorable ones, I thought, with A.D. Lewis and Stephen Oates for the British Championship, which he still holds, by the way. He's defended it four times, but he'll have to give back the Lonsdale belt if he wins this WBU title tonight.
Well,
shame, isn't it?
It's a big shame, because obviously, you know, he'll be very keen on his Lonsdale belt, the prestigious British title that it is.
Well, here he comes then, the home city fighter, Nicky Booth. These Booth brothers have lit up the scene, the boxing scene in Nottingham in recent years. Become very popular local heroes. He's enjoying this ring entrance, isn't he?
Well, he's certainly been taking long enough about it, isn't it? I think he's went 20 yards. It's the longest time I think anybody's ever took to move that far.
Brings a bit of attitude into the ring with him, Nicky Booth, but he usually delivers when he gets there.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ring now the champion from the Gold Coast, Australia, the real thing, Nathan Sting.
Well, I think this is an improved fighter, this Nathan Sting. He's a slippery southpaw and fancies his chances a lot of coming to Britain and winning again, as he did against Johnny Armour. All over in the 11th round that night, Sting did a number on him. I don't know whether Armour had been fatigued a bit by those three hard fights he had with Francis Ampofa, mind you.
Well, that could be true. I think Nicky Booth may be at a different proposition, because he's a lot quicker than Armour, who was at the tail end of a career. And as you say, it was a hard career. So I think this is very different. Nicky Booth would be much liver opponent, and would be really trying to put some pressure on Sting. But Sting is a very good boxer, and he's a southpaw, and that's where Nicky Booth does have his problems.
Sting's a Tasmanian of Indian descent. And it won't bother him fighting Booth here away from home. Tale of the tape. Tonight looks like this. Booth is 7 years younger at 23. Height, the same. Reach, not a lot in it really. And both of them just an ounce or two inside the 8 stone, 6 pound bantamweight limit. Booth's been a pro for 5 years now, Sting much more experience, more fights, more rounds boxed, and he's got a slightly better knockout percentage, though neither of them are what you'd call mega punches.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and welcome along to the Harvey Hadden Sports Centre here in the delightful and historical city of Nottingham, England. John Shepherd for Ringside Boxing Promotions, in association with Prince Promotions and Matchroom Sport, proudly present 12 rounds of boxing for the WBU Bantamweight Championship. Sponsored by PokerMillion.com for a great game of online poker. And a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us live and exclusive here on Sky Sports. You've joined us for the very best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the WBU president, John Robinson, acting as supervisor here at ringside in association with the British Boxing Board of Control. The timekeeper, Mr. Harry Vauxhall. Our three medical officers, Dr. Chowdhury, Dr. Sharp, and Dr. Saraso. Our three scoring judges from South Africa, Howard Goldberg. From England, Carl Rogers. From England, Reg Thompson. And the referee in charge of the action from Edmonton, England, Dave Paris. They are the officials, here are the contestants, and firstly, introducing to you the challenger, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black trunks and weighing in at 8 stone, 5 pounds, 13 ounces, with a 22 fight record, 17 wins, 7 inside the scheduled distance, 4 losses and 1 draw. He is the reigning British champion. Ladies and gentlemen from Nottingham, please welcome once more, Nicky. He's fighting out of the red corner wearing the blue trunks. Weighing in at 8 stone, 5 pounds, 13 ounces, bringing a 33 fight record, 26 wins, 13 inside the scheduled distance, 6 losses, 1 draw. Making his first defense, he is the reigning and defending WBU Bantamweight Champion. Would you please welcome from the Gold Coast, Australia, for the WBU Bantamweight Championship.
I've heard a lot of words, I spoke with you in the dressing room. Break when I tell you to, defend yourself all the time. Shake hands, boys. Come on, shake hands. Good luck to you both.
Referee Dave Paris. These two were due to meet for the Commonwealth title last year, but that didn't happen. This one does, and Sting says he's been waiting to get Nicky Booth in the same ring for some time. He fancies the job. Expect Booth to be the aggressor here, but it'll have to be educated aggression from him, because Sting loves to counterpunch, and in the past Nicky Booth has had real trouble with southpaws, decent class ones like Steve Molitor, the Canadian, and Jose San Juanelo, both of whom beat him and beat him well too. So will he struggle with the style? That's a big question in this fight, Glenn.
Yes, it is a big question. He's got to get in range, he's got to get working, you know. If Sting can just upset the rhythm, that's when Nicky Booth does have the problem. So he's got to really try and get the momentum going and start putting the pressure on Sting.
But he'll have to be careful of the counter-punching, because I think Sting would quite fancy it if Booth came at him in straight lines. Yeah. Booth found out a couple of times when he's been moved up a notch in class, but he's been the boss in Britain all right.
Well, he's got to find a way in, staying good behind the southpaw jab, and Booth has to try and nullify that jab, get close.
And a warning early on for Nicky Booth. Good right hand. I'd say if he wins this one, it'd be about his best win in his career, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I think it would be. It'd be a good step up for Nicky Booth.
Particularly because Sting is banging forward and very confident at the moment. Good body shots got in there from Booth. He's going to have to be cute tonight.
He's going to have to be educated pressure that we get from Booth. Can't just rush in and get caught with a jab.
Hope he's done a bit more homework than when he fought San Juanelo at late notice and got taken apart in nine. Asked him if he'd seen anything. He said, "Now, don't bother with that." But maybe he's matured and knows a bit more now. You'd like to think so. Surely watch videos of this guy, plenty available. He's been to Britain before, lost on points to Neil Swain, beat Stephen Oates, who's one of Nicky Booth's victims.
Well, he's doing all right here, Booth. He's managing to miss a lot of the shots and get through with his own. Sting just falling short with the jab, and I think that's allowing Booth to get in close.
Quite a lot hitting gloves and arms in this first round. Good right hand from Booth, who's for the most part tried to make the fight. Welcome back in the ring, Nicky Booth, backstage waiting to fight his brother Jason, who fights Lunga Ntontela later on. Is he watching his brother? There's the answer, no. He's relaxing. Not asleep like Lennox Lewis often is in the dressing room.
Well, he's doing the right thing, just getting concentrated on his own job.
Second round of this one, Nicky Booth, black trunks, the Tasmanian Nathan Sting, who's 7 years older at 30. His record, 20 wins, 6 defeats and a draw so far, but he's won his last 6, including picking up this WBU title. Significantly, Sting hasn't managed to develop any kind of rhythm in the fight yet.
No, he's got to get his jab on. That's where he can start working. And you know, it's always an orthodox southpaw. It's always who manages to get the jab, who manages to deal with that. That's the one who gets off to the better start.
Sometimes Booth just content to say to Sting, "Well, you come in at me, you lead. And I'll try and counter you sometimes as well." Now they stand toe-to-toe. He is a mover, Nathan Sting. That's what he likes doing, spearing out that southpaw jab, getting away again. Raiding tactics. Or counter-punching.
But I think against Booth, he's going to need a little bit more than that.
Good left hand. The decisive punch in the rally twice over from Booth, who's useful with that left hook.
Booth just seeing that he has more authority in his punches.
Again, he nails Sting with a left hook. That's where he wants him, on those ropes. That's a good place for Booth, and not so good for Sting. This is Booth imposing his will on the Tasmanian.
Sting's being drawn into Booth's type of fight, which is not good for Sting.
And I think Nicky Booth's been quite clever. He's not rushing in, he's thinking about it. Right hands twice over two from Nicky Booth, and the left hand as well. Sting having the odd success, but just being out hit a bit here in this second round. Yeah. stuff this from Booth. Looks strong. Looking like the boss early on here.
Well, it's the wrong tactics from Sting. He's trying to stand in front of Booth as if he's got something to prove, and really that's the wrong tactics.
Now he's on his bike again, but not for long. I think Sting needs to be keeping this on the outside. Hasn't managed to do that, and I think Big Boob has probably won the first two.
That's what he's got. He's going to have it for a long time.
Father and son team in the corner. Jason and Mike Shinfield, well-known Midlands fight figures from Alfreton.
Well, I think they'll be pleased with the start that Booth has made. It's been a good start. He hasn't rushed in. He's bided his time. He's looked for the openings. And then when Sting has been in front of him, then he's got the better shots on of the two. He's more accurate, and he just looks as if he's got more firepower than Sting.
Although he's only stopped 7 of 17 victims.
That's right, but it just looks as if he's got more in his punches than Sting.
Third round, black trunks, Nicky Booth, old Nottingham, looking to pick up the WBU Bantamweight Championship tonight. Not the World Bantamweight Championship, the WBU Bantamweight Championship, just to put it in context, different thing. Corner have told him to try to keep things at range a little.
Yeah, he's got to be in and out, side to side. You're not really giving Booth any target area.
Put him with a nice right crossing there in that exchange.
Got to start using that right hand before the hand head.
Doubles up on the hooks, Nicky Booth. A bit better from Sting though in this round. He's just made it a bit more his kind of argument and strategy. Not standing in front of Booth quite as much. Setting him one or two other questions, the kind of questions we thought he might set from the beginning.
Well, in the corner, probably have said you've got to change your tactics because you adopt the wrong ones, but this is better from Sting now, who's keeping on the move and then stopping throwing his shots, then back on the move again.
Sting has come back well here in the third.
Yeah, Sting's up the work, they're throwing more punches now.
Trained by Les Wilson in a gym on the Gold Coast of Queensland, about 3 hours out of Brisbane. Good left hook from Booth, but he'll need more than that to take away this round late on from Sting. Oh, and a solid right two through the middle from Nicky Booth.
Big give cut, nice. Sting just getting the arms moving.
Not the style Nicky Booth likes to face, or hasn't so far in his career anyway, a slippery southpaw.
Nice movement there from Sting. Didn't capitalize on making Booth miss though.
Watching at ringside, Johnny Armour in those three memorable battles with Francis Ampofo. Been a terrific little fighter, but beaten quite easily by one of the guys in the ring here, Nathan Sting, in his last fight. It'd been the wrong style for him as well, wouldn't it?
Yeah, there would be the wrong style.
Well, if he doesn't fight again, Johnny Armour, he's been certainly good value. He hasn't mentioned retirement, mind you. hasn't told us about it anyway.
Well, probably not in his mind if he's in a fight like this.
Fourth round. Booth looking to re-establish control. Sting improved in the third round and made it just a bit more his kind of fight. Fighters from Australasia, with a few notable exceptions, have been quite disappointing usually on the world stage. Exceptions including, of course, Jeff Fennec, Jeff Harding, remember those battles with Dennis Andres.
Well, he's just got a little bit more movement and a bit more work rate, Sting. And I think that that's suiting him. I think he's got to try and close the gap down a little bit quicker. Nicky Booth, he's just standing out too long, showing Sting too much respect.
Yeah, not closing the range down. Wants to get him into a brawl on the ropes. That's what Booth would like, to try to pin him there as well, but Sting escapes again. He's well named, isn't he?
He is, yeah, he's in and out, and fast little punches.
Wasp-like tactics, really.
Not a big puncher, but yeah, he gets the shots in, he's very accurate and quick. Only 13 inside schedule wins and 33 fights. Just proves that lack of punch power.
A decent mobility, can slide around and frustrate his opponents. Booth gets there with the right hand this time. More like it for Booth here in this round. Just changed again, hasn't it, here in the fourth. Not so mobile, Sting again, and a body punch drives him back against the ropes.
Better now from Booth, who's getting his shots off.
Making Sting miss a bit and drives him back with the right. It's just a suggestion too, there's a bit more about Booth's work. The body shot, keep them up, says Dave Parris, the referee. Oh, and that looked low. Yeah, from Booth right at the end of the round. I think he won that round. Their returns now. Ricky Hatton is back in action next Saturday night against Aldo Rios. Saturday fight night from 8 next week on Sky Sports 1. Here in Nottingham, it looks like the Booth Brothers show might not run entirely smoothly. Fifth round. Thanks, Paul. Black trunks, remember, Nicky Booth. The blue of Nathan Sting. This is his sixth appearance in Britain. Wins over Johnny Armour and Stephen Oates against defeats by Neil Swain, Paul Lloyd, and the Russian Dmitry Kirillov. So he is beatable, all right.
I think he can be broken down, Ken Sting. But it's not easy. I think he has improved over the years.
Good body shot. Booth using the body attacks in an attempt to slow down the mover. Classic tactics. That had to be a part of the strategy. Sting's not moving that much, is he, in this round?
Not getting caught with shots there. It's certainly not the tactics he needs to adopt, Sting.
Nicky Booth, at his level, can be quite a handful. And his level's a pretty good one.
Picking the better, solider shots in there, Booth. Sting missing with a few.
did enough against Johnny Armour for them to fling in the towel from Armour's corner in the 11th. Did a number on him. But I think he's finding Booth quite strong in there. That's a good body shot, mind you, from Sting.
Yep, that was good. He just don't let the shots go. A little more venom in the shots from Sting. Good work on the ropes from Sting and coming off the ropes.
He's throwing a lot of leather and these body shots look good. I think he's hurt Booth with one of those. He wanted to cover up Booth for a moment, bide his time. And Sting just starting here to get through with some uppercuts. I think the body punches might have started it for him.
Yeah, he slowed down. He's been hurt. Getting caught with shots here.
Booth came back with a couple of good right hands in there. But Sting here fancies that he's got Booth on the run a little. Looking strong. Booth, I think, has gone through a crisis in there in this round. Not sure his head's totally cleared even now.
No, it was good right hand in there from Sting.
Good round that for Nathan Sting, who raised the stakes at Gambled and won. Was that a breakthrough round for Nathan Sting? It looked like it.
It certainly was a breakthrough round. That was very, very good. He definitely hurt Booth in there, shook him up, and you know, there's some nose damage and some damage around the eye, but some good shots. He really just bent his knees. You could see he'd hurt him, put a little more venom into the shots, really meant them. Yeah, he's bending the knees, he's trying to get that, the power, trying to bring those shots up.
When he went back to the corner at the end of that round, Nicky Booth still looked a little bit dazed to me.
Yeah, he did. That was a good right hoof from Sting, and that took a bit out of Booth.
Or was that the round, the fifth? Here comes round six. Sting was planting his feet more for some of those shots. The next chapter will be very interesting here. Blue Trunks, remember Nathan Sting. Moves confidently. Plenty of defeats on Sting's record, but not lately. He was knocked out in two by one of Scott Harrison's victims, Tony Wabey. I just wonder if this is a fighter who is about at the peak of his career now at 30. He's a dedicated kind of fighter who wants to learn.
They keep catching Booth with these stinging shots.
Booth backs off for a moment, almost as if he wants Sting to do the leading. Cat and mouse. Good right cross in there from Sting. Hook, I should say. And again.
Turn him again. I think he backs off.
He smiles through the gum shield at him. And then Sting gives him a body shot for good measure. Definite change in the mood last couple of rounds. Just a sign that Nathan Sting is beginning to get to Nicky Booth here. Blood from his nose, it might be affecting his breathing a bit as well. Booth.
Well, he's trying to force Sting back with some good body shots.
And he needs to be able to sustain that body attack. He's really going to be affected in weakening Sting.
Tell he doesn't like the southpaw stance, Booth, because at times he doesn't really know where to get out of the way of the shots.
There's the right hand, the classic tactics against the southpaw. Maybe Booth should be looking for that a bit more. There's another body shot. It's not all Sting by any means. Booth comes back well. last few seconds here of the six. Goes orthodox for a moment, Sting. Fascinatingly poised fight here at bantamweight. Nicky Boo, one of the local heroes in the black trunks, but Nathan Sting has picked up the pace over the last couple of rounds, the Tasmanian.
He has, and Boo towards the end of the run tried to pick it up again to get back in a little bit, but Sting's not having any of it. He's got the bit between his teeth and he's planning his shots better.
Seventh round. Booth tried going southpaw for a few seconds towards the end of that last round, but he's come out back to orthodox here. Maybe a sign that he feels he needs to do something different. Just wonder whether these body shots just might take their toll on Sting late on.
Yeah, they both been looking to land with good solid shots, and nice body shots from Booth.
All the time he's looking to dig them in under the ribs here. He wants to slow down the mover. Take the body, and the legs might go too. This is good from Booth, better. Good start to the round from him. He's going for some good body punches, Glenn.
Yeah, not as well as Sting elected to stay there. He didn't try and get off the ropes.
Brave and gutsy fighter, Nicky Boo, had to take a right hand as he tried to pull Sting back against the ropes there.
Good from Boo, strong shots.
Yeah, and not so much coming back either. Not much that's accurate anyway from Sting. This is Boo looking to re-establish himself, and how in this round. He's had much the better of it so far in this session. But here comes Sting again. It's good fight.
He's warming up very much.
Oh, and he's rocked him back with that right hand against the ropes. Cracking round this one so far.
Well, Sting had to come back, had to try something. Now it's changed round and it's Booth on the ropes.
Totally turned round. Booth, great start to the round. Sting has done excellently in the last three quarters of a minute or so.
Sting doing some good work with his back against the ropes.
100%. Fortune's fluctuating. Here comes Booth's turn to nail Sting against it. Came back with a couple of his own too, mind you, but it's Booth who's getting the better of it. He's landing more than matters, I think. Right cross, hook is tremendous action. People at the back of the hall are off their seats watching this.
Well, you need to do this, Nicky Booth. You need to go all out, up the work grid, really testing.
It's tremendous battle here in the seventh.
Great
best round
there
of the fight.
Good left hook again from Sting. Just give himself a bit of room.
Marked up around the face as he goes back. They have been working on a bit of damage. Well, Sting had a very good patch in the middle of that round, but Boo seemed to dominate it at the beginning and end. So I give him the round. Look how many punches were thrown in that last round. Take a check on the computer here. Boo threw 104, Sting 83. Not so many landed, mind you, 33 for Boo. And a bit less for Sting.
Yep, he did well there. Nicky Booth got caught with a good shot there. The left hand put him back against the ropes, but he made a good recovery and really put the pressure on Sting to finish that round really well. Sting against the ropes and Booth just laying away with shots.
Good fight this one, with first one fella, then the other, taking control for phases of the fight. Now what? Round 8.
Sit down anymore.
Well, I've just got 1 point and 67-66 in Booth's favour with that last round, just him moving ahead.
Yeah, I've got Booth by one as well, Glenn, by a different route to you, I think. But there's very, very little in this. It's all up for grabs.
I think the key with both these men can be the body shots. I think that should be the good target that either one can get ahead with.
Who can sustain the pressure, the intensity of the work rate in what's becoming a furnace of a fight?
Sting picking the better of the shots, he's electing to steer there. I think that's testament to Booth's lack of punch power that Sting can steer in there.
Well, I don't think either of them are knockout punches, are they? These two right hands and left hook from Booth. Does Sting want to be there, or is he being kept in there by Booth? Booth, listen to the crowd roar as they sense their man is getting the better of the argument. This is what he likes, though, Nicky Booth. This is his kind of territory. And Sting is quite happy to stand there in front of him. Is that the right strategy for him?
Well, it's blood from the nose. I think the breathing could be getting difficult from Booth. The Sting comes and tries to force the fight again.
Here comes Sting in the ascendancy. Something has to give. That's a solid left by Sting. Booth's gloves drop for a moment. But back he comes, the gutsy little operators these two are. Well, it was a good fight, and it's becoming something a bit more than that. A lot of blood now from Booth's nose.
Booth just looking to be weakened by some of these heavy shots from Sting. Sting getting the better of this round.
In a right cross and left hand against Sting, but he's back to the ropes. He doesn't seem to mind fighting there.
It was a good right hook from Sting, which shook Booth a little bit. Under a bit of pressure, Nicky Booth.
Well, tremendous action. They haven't heard the bell. They need the minute's rest. Take the 60 seconds, boys. It's great stuff.
There of Nicky Booth. He looked as if he was hurt a couple of times in that round. I think body shots hurt him. There's a right hand there. He got some good shots on himself, but the better ones for me were from Nathan Sting.
You wouldn't want your money back, though, if you'd paid to get in, would you, for this?
No, you certainly wouldn't. It's a good fight, and Sting really trying to make it in there with good barrage of punches. Winning the round.
Four rounds to go. WBU Bantamweight Championship. Nicky Booth, black trunks, looking to win this championship. Give up his British title should he win this in the British Boxing Board of Control current regulations. Booth elects to go backwards at the start of this round. Last two rounds have been very, very intense.
Just changing tactics now, keeping out of range, using his long punches to pick up the points.
Maybe both of them with a mind to the fact that this could go the whole way. And they're both thinking, we've got to pace this. Tight on the scorecards, I would suggest. I think this fight's to be won over the last four rounds, isn't it, Glenn?
Yeah, it is on my card. I've got this fight dead level as it stands at the moment. And it's toot and fraud through the round, 76 all. And what is a very good contest would get for the winning.
Sting back to jab and move. Off the ropes this time. They've had two fights in one almost here. The barroom brawling on the ropes and then out in centre ring. Booth takes a heavy looking shot. Hurt by that one as well. Needed a bit of time. Sting getting the better of the argument for me in this ninth round.
Yeah, more controlled. The boxing's been from Sting.
And I think he's hurt Booth again. Sucks it all up, Nicky Booth. Tries to fire back, but it's one of those fights where you feel something has to wilt, something has to give, maybe late on.
Picked two nice right hands, Nicky Booth. Welcome. Cheers from the crowd.
Just wondering about Booth's legs a bit as well. Seemed to kind of stumble across the ring there, rather. Time out, says Dave Paris. He had the his gloves round the back of the head of Sting. Let's go backstage now.
Yes, and as you noticed earlier, Jason Booth hasn't been watching any of his brother Nicky's fight. Jason, what's the reasoning behind that?
Well, I've got to prepare myself as well, and I know I'm behind my brother in my heart. Hope he's doing well. Come on, Nick. Chris Aston's taking me on pads, and I'm getting sharp. That's what I'm doing.
Would it give you a tremendous boost if Nicky were to win?
Yeah, of course it will.
Of course, you're up against this tough guy, Lunga Ntontela.
Yeah,
how are you going to approach this one?
I'm going to box like, I'm going to dazzle him on. I'm just going to be the best I can be when I'm in that ring, and I'll find out as soon as I get in there, no doubt.
What would it mean to your career to win tonight?
Everything.
Thanks for talking to us.
Good decision, I think, by Jason Booth not to watch his brother, because you'd get emotionally drained, wouldn't you, watching your brother in a fight like this?
Yeah, it's a good fight, and he'd just be absorbed by it, and it would take too much out of him, and he's just got to get on with the job at hand for himself.
Round 10. Feeling at the moment is that Sting's had the better of the last couple of sessions. Is he assuming control? Have Nicky Booth's legs just gone a little? And since he's been hurt a few times in this fight and come through it. Two strong, determined, well-conditioned fighters in there. Let's see if there are any signs of Sting feeling the pace of the contest, as Booth does find a good right hand.
Sting's 30, and on the older legs, Booth just 23. Pressure of the two.
On paper, anyway.
Yep.
So much in Booth's punches as he's clipped by the right hand of Sting again.
I think they're both feeling the pace. It's showing a bit. There's much snap in the punches of either man.
Quiet around this one, but you can hardly complain because these two have provided some great action at times. Trying to take it to Sting a bit more, but not so much snap about his work, really. I think you're right, they are feeling the pace, Glenn.
Well, they'll be looking for a second wind, these fighters.
I think Sting's tired a bit here, you know.
Yeah, he has. There's certainly been a little bit of a lift.
Yeah, I think he has. Booth. Quite noticeably in this round, he's done a lot less. This could be a question of who has most left. There might even be a bit of late drama with two tired fighters. This is one of the quietest rounds of the fight. Maybe they're gathering himself for the big finish.
Well, the quiet round with Booth, doing a bit more at the end to clinch it for him.
Yeah, you have to give it to him. I don't think it was a lot in his work, but he did most of it. And that on my card levels it up again.
Same with me. 7-1-2, he's throwing more punches, Booth, to 6-1-10, and landing more.
Landed a lot more.
Yeah.
So what does the computer know that we don't?
Yeah, significantly more, but on my card I've got this level. 95-95, and it has to the fraud. Been a good contest.
This could be a close one. Howard Goldberg from South Africa, Carl Rogers and Rich Thompson of England are the three judges scoring it. They've given so much, but the winner is going to have to give a bit more in the last 6 minutes, you sense here. Of an argument that's swayed this way and that. Now, on they come with a lot more purpose and menace about the work.
Well, I think the pro probably being told this is pretty close. Two rounds to go, you've got to start working, boys.
Or continue working.
Yeah, continue, yeah. Not start. It's doing them a disservice, isn't it?
It is. I think the barrel's running a bit dry for both of these two in there. They've provided quite a spectacle at times, though, here. Not for the first time in the case of Nicky Boo that he's in a very good fight. Doesn't seem to be in too many bad ones. Getting in with those body shots. Are they beginning to take their toll here? He's made a particular target of the body in this fight, Boo.
Well, he's got to keep it going. It's important just to keep the arms moving, the punches landing.
Gumshoe, I think, might have come out for one of the fighters there. Well, certainly something flew across the ring. Unless somebody threw something in it. Good little burst from Sting.
Yeah, Sting now starting to get on top. Good shots from him.
Yeah, punches and punches from Nathan Sting.
Well, they're both having their successes in this round. Sting trying to pick it up.
Sting's doing more. Is more authoritative from Sting. It was a good left hook back, mind you, from Booth there, and a very solid looking right hand as well. And more than one of them.
Sting just leaving himself open as he tries to get these punches off and get the power in them.
This could end up being a pretty close call. Sting, good finish to the round here. Boo hurt again, retreats to the ropes. He's picking it up well. This is a big-ish round, I think, for Nathan Sting.
Well, it shows the character of both men that then Boo can try and turn his man, but that was Sting's important round.
There's only 3 minutes to go, but you wouldn't want to call the winner from here.
You wouldn't. I just Sting did more in that round, and he edges ahead, but not in punches landed.
Just a guide from the computer. There's 3 minutes left in what's been an intense fight, which has taken its toll. You sense on both of them that who's strongest late on. Sting's had 12, scheduled 12 rounders, and Booth 8. Sting's completed the distance 6 times and Booth 3 times. But this one will be one of the hardest fights of both men's careers.
Yeah, 1 point in it in Sting's favour. So a very, very close fight.
Yep, that's what I've got it to. So Booth, Glenn and I feel, needs this last round. But Sting starts it fast, very fast. He knows he's fighting away from home as well, too. And as we so often say, it shouldn't be a factor, but it often is. Certainly something to just mix into your thinking. Sting ramming in those left hands from his southpaw stance.
Well, it's a test of character now, and who wants it more? Who's going to give that little bit extra dig, the deeper of the two?
No doubt about it, Sting looks stronger now. Does to me, anyway.
Yeah, he does. He's finished the better of the two. More bounce in his step.
Booth's looked on quite heavy legs and is driven back by another left hand. Is Nicky Booth, the British champion, heading for a third defeat as he moves up in class, as he did against Jose Samuelo and Steve Molitor, the talented Canadian?
Well, wouldn't it be strange if he loses to a third southpaw?
Yeah, maybe not so strange.
His long right hand from Booth, but it's work rate he needs, not the single shots.
Easy for us to say, isn't it? Keep throwing leather, but he must be aching and bruised now and having to dig pretty deep. And a wearying battle, and Sting here is finding a big finish.
Yep.
Or big-ish, anyway.
Good work over the last two rounds from Sting.
He's winning this last round, the Tasmanian. Looks like that, anyway. And again, Booth is caught by a left hand and has to step off. Needs to be careful here. Just dropped his gloves for a moment. Coming up to the last half a minute of what's been a very good fight.
Well, he's just not going to be denied, is he, Nathan Sting? He's going to keep those shots coming out, keep the punches landing and moving.
And I have to say, even though he's at home, I don't think Nicky Booth has done quite enough to take Sting's title away.
I agree with you, and I don't think he has. It's been a very good, hard-fought contest. We have enjoyed it.
I think Sting won the last two rounds and with it the fight. But that's only our interpretation. They both put on a splendid show. Take your hats off to both fighters there. But quite a battle. Nicky Booth again up against a southpaw, finding life difficult. But he gave Sting plenty to think about, but the Tasmanian found a pretty good finish. How did the judges see it? I wonder.
And the new champ.
I've got Sting a 2-point winner at the end of it all. There's the computer which says that Booth did land more punches in the fight.
Well, I've agreed with you, Ian. I've got Nathan Sting, a 2-point winner, doing it in the last two rounds on a level at the end of the 10th, and then Sting just coming off with more shots and more intensity. Come at 115, 113 on my unofficial scorecard.
7 rounds to 5. Sorry, not moving the head, but listen, go anyway, son. Spencer Oliver, our own Spencer Oliver, having a chat with Nicky. An inquest before the decision. Well, let's see. Let's see which way it's gone here. Here we go. John McDonald, our MC, has news for us.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 fantastic rounds of championship boxing, the referee's judges read. Judge Reg Thompson, 115-113. Judge Carl Rogers, 115-113. And Judge Howard Goldberg, 116-112. All three judges are in favour of. And still,
Nathan Sting has kept his title. It goes against Nicky Booth. He's heartbroken about it. It was a close-ish one, but I don't think he can really complain. Sting did enough down the stretch.
And ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation.
I don't think Nicky Booth lost an awful lot in defeat that time, do you?
No, I don't think he did. He fought very, very hard. Good fight, but I think they got the judging, they got the scorecards about right, and he deserved to win.
On two of the cards by 2 points, on the other one by 4 points, Nathan Sting beats Nicky Booth and holds on to his WBU bantamweight title. Spencer Oliver was in animated conversation with Nicky Booth while he awaited the result. What were your thoughts on the outcome first?
Well, the outcome is exactly what I scored. I had it two rounds in favour of Sting. Some of the rounds were close, but Nicky's problem, as I said to him, he started off with the right tactics, coming in low, moving that head all the time, but as the fight went on, he neglected the moving of the head and allowed Sting to take over.
Is it that old southpaw problem? It's 3 out of 3 defeats against them now.
Yeah, I mean, he does struggle with southpaws. He gets caught repeatedly by the straight left hand. But he just neglected the second half of the fight. He stopped moving his head. He was just concentrating on throwing his own punches and was getting caught by whatever Sting was throwing at him.
Nonetheless, there was always the possibility that he might get a grip on the fight. And were you mystified slightly by Sting's approach here tonight?
I was. I mean, Sting should have been boxing and moving all the time and just gradually, as Booth was coming in, Booth was leaving himself open. Sting, when he boxed on the outside, boxed perfectly and was really making it easy for himself. But he decided to try and outman Booth and stand with him, and that was the wrong tactics, and he made it hard for himself. After 10 rounds, I had it all level. It was only on the last two rounds.
Sheer willpower and that home support not quite enough here for one Booth then in Nottingham. What about Jason? He's next up here tonight. Spencer?
Yeah, Jason Booth. This is his chance to do it on home soil. I mean, we've seen him foul 3 times in European title bids and they've all been abroad, so this is his big time now to do it on home soil. I mean, he, to me, is the better technician out of the two and I feel that he can do it here this evening.
What's he up against? It's a young South African here tonight and not a lot known in this country, but how has Jason got to impose himself on the job the way his brother perhaps has just failed to do?
Jason himself boxing another tough South African, 10 fights, 6 knockouts. So all we know is he's got Vianney Bungu, the former European super bantamweight title holder, in the corner, so he must be a decent fighter. And all we know is he's a slugger. I spoke to Jason in the dressing rooms. He told me he's going to come out here and he's just going to box. Jason's the cuter of the two brothers. He knows how to box a bit more, move that head, and that's exactly what he's got to do.
Thank you, Spencer. One other thing that is known about Ntontela, the young South African, he is from one of the hardest breeding grounds anywhere in world boxing. And we've seen plenty of his fellow countrymen coming to win here in international class. Booth loves fighting in front of a Nottingham crowd, but he might need them to lift him if it gets hard here. Premiership action on Sunday from 1:30, our regular pay-per-view match this week. Middlesbrough against Everton. For further information on how to order this one, Sky Digital viewers, please tune to channel 433 and follow the instructions. Cable customers, contact your local operator. And on Super Sunday, it's Old Trafford for Manchester United against Arsenal. It's live from 3 on Sky Sports 1. Jason Booth may well have found out his brother's fate by now, but can he turn one family disappointment to his advantage here tonight in Nottingham? Straight to our super flyweight title action now. Let's rejoin John McDonald.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue our championship boxing. Please welcome to the ring now, from Nottingham, Too Smooth, Jason Booth.
Well, he didn't watch his brother's fight earlier on. I suspect he probably knows the result by now, or does he? Was he trying to stay away from it all and just prepare for what he's got to do?
Well, I think he'll want to know the result. He's probably saw his brother go in the dressing room. Bit of a disappointment for Jason, but he's got to put that out of his mind now and get down to his job and the business in hand.
He has to make sure it's not a dose of double disappointment for the boxing brothers Booth from Nottingham tonight. Jason Booth, who can dazzle at times, he's an old school type who said he only really ever wanted to fight for British, European and genuine world titles. Well, needs must, he's in for the IBO super flyweight title tonight. Now that's 3 pounds up from his normal weight of flyweight. Doesn't sound a lot, but it could be, couldn't it?
It could be, but I think it might help him. He's got a big kid and that might just give him a little bit more room for manoeuvre, make life a little more comfortable. And you might see him better for it.
Might not have been quite as tough a battle to boil down to the weight. Good fighter, Jason Booth.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the champion from East London, South Africa, Mad Dog Lunga Ntontela.
Well, look how emotional he is. Lunga Ntontela. What does that look say?
I'm not really sure. He looks in pain, to be honest.
Well, I'm glad he's fighting Jason Booth and not me tonight.
Well, he does seem a bit of a character, doesn't he? He's got this name, Mad Dog. He's undefeated, 10 fights, 10 wins, and 6 inside schedule, so he's obviously got something.
Well, did you see the interview he did earlier on with Craig Slater? He says, I'm a mad dog, and I'm going to be fighting like a mad dog.
Well, he's supposed to be aggressive, come forward, throw his shots, and pulls his way in. Well, that suits the nice style of Jason Booth.
Well, the word from South Africa is he's a slugger with a bit of a dig, but he's quite raw and inexperienced. Could be outboxed by Booth. Could be. Well, we're all set to go here for the IBO super flyweight title held by Ntontela, the mad dog from East London, South Africa.
Ladies and gentlemen, John Shepherd for Ringside Boxing Promotions in association with Prince Promotions and Matchroom Sport proudly presents 12 rounds of boxing for the IBO Super Flyweight Championship. Sponsored by PokerMillion.com for a great game of online poker. All the officials have been appointed by the IBO President Ed Levine in association with the British Boxing Board of Control. The fight supervisor from Ham, Surrey is Mr. Charlie Payne. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Norman Maddox. And steward in charge from the British Boxing Board of Control is Mr. Les Potts. Our 3 medical officers, Dr. Chowdhury, Dr. Saraso, and Dr. Sharp. Our 3 scoring judges here at ringside, from South Africa, Pacamelia Jacobs, from the USA, Mark Streisner, and from England, Paul Thomas. Referee in charge of the action from Birmingham, England, is Mr. Terry O'Connor. Ladies and gentlemen, they were the officials, and here are the contestants. Firstly, the challenger. He's fighting under the blue corner, wearing the blue trunks, weighing in at 8 stone 2.5 pounds and bringing a 26 fight record, 23 wins, 10 inside the scheduled distance, and 3 losses. Coming to the ring as the current British flyweight champion, ladies and gentlemen from Nottingham, please welcome Too Smooth, Jason Booth. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the champion. He's fighting out of the red corner wearing the white trunks, weighing in at 8 stone 2.75 pounds. Undefeated, 10 contests, 10 wins, 6 inside the scheduled distance, making his first defense. He is the reigning and defending IBO Super Flyweight Champion from East London, South Africa, where he is known as Ntontela. So, sports fans and Sky Sports fans, let's get the action underway. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBO Super Flyweight Championship.
Terry O'Connor from Birmingham is the referee for this one. Here's what he has to say.
All right, I suppose you're in a changing room. Best lots of both. Here we go.
The answer is not much, but not much needs to be said, of course. They both know the job, or should do anyway by now. Could be a case of the smooth, sometimes dazzling skills of Jason Booth against the slugging of this Lunga Ntontela. His name looks like Ntontela, to look at it on paper, but I'm told reliably that you miss off the first N when you pronounce it. He's only had 10 fights, but he's already won the South African Championship and IBO too. Boxing out of the southpaw stance with the white trunks. Ntontela. Jason Booth, who's held British and Commonwealth titles at flyweight.
Well, is Jason going to deal with the southpaw stance any better than his brother did?
Jason, the less extrovert of the two brothers. 25, pretty mature pro now. 23 wins, 3 defeats, but those 3 defeats, all honourable efforts in European Championship bids away from home. In one of them, he actually floored the world-class David Guerrero before losing on points. Close one against Alexander Mamutov, and then beaten on a technical decision by Mimoun Shan. So he's never been hammered in there, Jason Booth. Biggest problem came out of the ring when he was hit over the head by an iron bar by a thug who was unconscious, hospitalized. It looked like the end of his career a year or so back. He's come back from that. And thank goodness for that.
Well, they're both just looking for the room and the range to get their shots on. Neither one managing to score with the jabs yet and find that range.
Good right hand, well picked from Jason Booth. I think he's just having a look at this guy, Ntontela. He knows he has the reputation of being quite a sharp puncher. Whipped in a few right hands there as he had him in close.
Ntontela looks like he might be able to be a bit heavy-handed with the left hand.
He's won all 10 so far, 6 inside schedule, Ntontela.
Together there. It can be a problem when there's orthodox and southpaw fighters together, lead foots opposite each other.
The body shot on the inside twice from Ntontela, 3 times in fact.
He's looked physically strong, only 21 years of age. So there might be plenty of time for improvement for Ntontela.
He probably still has that recklessness of youth about him. He's never been beaten and probably doesn't think he ever will be. Can be like that at that age.
He's walked onto a couple of shots from Booth. He's picked some nice snappy counters.
These two fighters have a common opponent, Abby Amnesi from South Africa, who floored Ntontela but lost to him because of work rate. And to be fair, Jason Booth beat Amnesi but struggled a bit himself. So I don't know what we draw from all of that.
Not a great deal.
Not much, no. But I thought I'd just put it in anyway.
Always good to hear these things.
Bit of bus stop conversation for you during the week. Second round, blue trunks, remember, Jason Booth, yet again boxing in front of his home fans, although his 3 European title fights have all been away from home. He could have done with one of them being here. Might have been the difference. How good is this Ntontela? How precocious a talent is he? I don't think they're that excited about him in South Africa. Not exactly rave reviews.
Well, he's only 21. He could just be having a, you know, quite a start, but he is unbeaten. So you've got to respect that unbeaten record.
British referees John Coyle and Roy Francis judged the fight when he won this IBO belt. That was against a Venezuelan veteran called Edison Torres, who was 34 years old, so I don't know how much we read into that. There's all kinds of people fighting for alleged world titles these days, and by and large, we should probably take not too much notice. Ridiculous number of championships, of course.
And he's trying to box the counter Booth, but Ntontela looks strong and he's making Booth work just to keep on the outskirts of the ring and out of range.
There's got to be raiding tactics here, you'd think, by Booth. Use speed, angles, movement to frustrate Ntontela.
Well, he's doing that. He's Ntontela pretty slow of hand because I think he's got a bit of power there.
Unlike in America, it would seem, you can win a fight on the back foot on this side of the Atlantic. I think sometimes in America you get points for just walking forward.
Nicely picked that right hand from Boone. This is good boxing from him.
Right hand from Boone, but he's just waved Ntontela in at him there, almost as if he wants him to come in and he can counter-punch him and get away again. Much more experienced, Boo, that could be a factor here. Still a bit novice-y, I should think, Ntontela.
Well, Ntontela obliging, he's coming forward. Booth moving well.
Trying to get the southpaw jab going, but not quite crafty enough or technically cute enough, Ntontela. And sweep sharp little left hand from Booth.
But do you think Booth's going to have to work for this? He's going to have to cover a lot of ground.
I think he's probably prepared to do it. His corner have told him not to get too involved. It worked in that round all right. Well, brotherly love is when you've just been beaten and been in a hard, grueling fight, to sit there without getting change, seeing if your brother can win.
Well, he put up a good performance. He's got nothing to be ashamed of. Now he wants to see what his brother can do.
Here we go. So far, so good for Jason. I think he's won the first two rounds here, muzzling the mad dog up to now. Round three, Booth, blue trunks. It's for the IBO super flyweight trinket. Ntontela gets closer.
I'm sure his corner have said, we need more work, Ridge. You're going to let these rounds slip away from you. You've got to get close the distance down and start throwing shots.
As I think they basically said to him, don't let him just go out there and be the dance master all night. You're going to have to cut off the corners. Question of whether Ntontela knows quite enough yet to know how to do that really effectively. Let's see. Started the round well, but he doesn't really want to be in here trying to box Booth from the outside. He wouldn't think so anyway.
Well, Booth picking off good shots using the left hand as an uppercut and then the right hand over the top, and Ntontela falling short with his own jab.
Could be that Ntontela manages to turn the thing on its head with one dynamic shot. We don't know that much about him, really. You hear reports, you see the record. He can't be that bad. He won the South African title in his eighth fight. That was a second round job. Mzini Denitsi, I think I've got the pronunciation just about right.
Well, there was a right hand from Booth which steadied up Ntontela. He just went backwards for the first time in this fight. And he's just putting a bit more power into his shots now, Booth, just growing in confidence.
He loads with the right and gets away again. Oh, to ooze a bit of confidence in there, Jason Booth. It's almost as if that boxing brain is starting to work out the fellow in front of him.
Lovely counter there with the left hook. Ntontela a little more bemused now, not knowing where these shots are coming from, and now he's on the back foot.
Still think Jason Booth is a potentially world-class flyweight. Boxing at super fly here, that's 8 stone 3 pounds, by the way, for those of you unfamiliar with this division. They don't have British titles at this weight.
Showing very good skills, teeing off with the left hand and then the right, and Ntontela is looking there. Ten fight novice he is.
Looking pretty thoughtful, Ntontela, as if to say, never thought of anybody quite like this before. This is a bit different. Oh, and he gets it with a left hand. That was more like it from the South African. He comes from East London and has welcome Nchita with him, a former world champion.
The MEN Arena in Manchester, it's a sellout, and it must be Ricky Hatton, Britain's top young light welterweight, in action against Aldo Rios next weekend on Saturday Fight Night from 8 on Sky Sports 1.
Yes, welcome in Cheetah, former world super bantamweight champion, who was beloved, much beloved of Nelson Mandela. He's a big boxing fan and used to box himself. That was because he went into the ring with the ANC flag. Good to see him here working the corner tonight for Lunga Ntontela. But Jason Booth has outboxed the South African so far, the unbeaten South African. No, that's not a knockdown. Just wrestled into the floor. Terry O'Connor has his usual unfussy word with Booth and just lets him get on with it.
Well, the mad dog's looking a bit like puppy dog at the minute. We're not seeing this aggression from him.
It was almost a wrestling hold there from Pooh. And Ntontela has chosen to make a lot of it. Says he's kind of wrenched a neck muscle by the look of it. I'm sure it was that bad, but I guess I wasn't the one held in the vice-like grip. Was that a distress signal from Ntontela?
I think it could well have been. He did grip pretty strongly around the neck, but I think that maybe just shows that he's a little bit unsettled now, Ntontela.
Because there's always the problem too, you just wonder whether some of these guys travel so well. He's been fighting in South Africa, who sets him back again there. Will-of-the-wisp type performances from Jason Booth.
Yeah, very good counter with the left hand. Just over that southpaw jab, and he really is giving the runaround, showing some good skills here.
Booth was a pro at 18, he's 25 now. He won his first 14, and he's still got a pretty good record as well. As I was telling you earlier, all his defeats really were with honour. Never really been taken apart or anything like that. And big things could still happen for him, you know. Possible,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, very much so, very much so. He just needs the right opportunities. He's a talented fighter.
I think he's well capable of winning the European title, particularly if they can engineer him a chance at home. And maybe beyond that too. Body shot from Ntontela. Keep the punches up. It looked like it landed all right to me, but Terry O'Connor, the referee's closer.
Trying to get closer to Booth now, and walk straight on with a lovely right hand.
Beautifully big left hand as well. It can be silky at times. A bit slappy, those left hands, possibly from Booth.
They're making an impression on Ntontela. He's certainly moving with them, so there's some power there. That's the shot Booth has to watch out for, that straight left.
He continues to do the better work, Jason Booth. Now then, let's have a look at this rather unfamiliar super flyweight division. worldwide. And those names pretty unfamiliar even to us, Greg. We've not seen too many of those in action.
No, we haven't. So pretty much well kept secret.
Well, Mark Johnson at the bottom we've seen, of course, a few times. Former flyweight champion he was, been around a fair old while.
Well, there's the little wrestle and move there from Booth. He did grab him with the neck, but he did make a little bit too much of it, Ntontela. Although I wasn't the one getting strangled. There's the sharp work, very, very crisp, isn't it? Very polished.
That's why they call him too smooth.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Fifth round of this one.
The good thing is he's got the jab working as well. It's often difficult against the southpaw, but he's beaten Ntontela to the jab.
It's cute boxing so far from Jason Booth, but he can't afford to switch off, you sense. It does look raw, the South African. You'd expect that, 21, only 10 fights, even if they are winning ones, including national titles and this IBO belt. To be associated with another world champion, Boyani Bungu, who we saw over here fighting Nassim Hamed. Hits him with a couple of left hands there, Ntontela. Concentration has to be excellent here, Booth.
Well, there's plenty of rounds to go, and your lack of concentration could mean danger.
Could be that Ntontela will feel the late rounds could be more his territory if Booth does slow. You'd think the tactics for Ntontela ought to be body shots to try to slow down Booth.
Well, he heard you there, Ian, because his two come right on cue.
Booth said something to him as well. Not sure what that was. Trying to be elusive, but just getting nailed a bit more in this round, Booth. He's getting to him a little, Ntontela. There's grounds for encouragement for his corner here. Booth isn't doing so much. He's just on the run, really.
Yep, he's missing with shots, and he's just getting, his style's getting a bit ruffled in there. He's got to get back to the smooth work.
Countering right was good from Booth. But this has been Ntontela's best round so far. Take one again on the counter, but he didn't seem to worry about that. He's just creeping that bit closer to Jason Booth.
Ntontela abandons those tactics, which were working for him. He was closing the distance down.
Well, he tried of giving Booth a bit of his own medicine there, jabbing away for a quarter of a minute or so.
Well, this is Tontella's round. He's been the more accurate and the busier.
And the conclusion to draw from that is that this argument's not over yet. Booth has outboxed this South African early on, but you sense there's still some danger left in the man they call Mad Dog, Lunga. Well, he couldn't have a better bloke in the corner than welcome Nchita to talk to him about strategy. He may lack experience himself, but Nchita will know what he should be doing and telling him.
Yeah, he'll know the right strategy, and it was working in that round. He was closing the distance down and, you know, stopping the work from Booth. Booth wasn't getting the jab on. I don't think he can afford to neglect that. That just keeps Ntontela at bay.
Sixth round of this one. Was there just a little shift in the pattern there in the fifth? It looked like it, didn't it? Blue trunks, remember, of Jason Booth. Remember, he's stepping up in weight as well. This fellow has been fighting at 8'3", and normally Booth fights at 8'. And as I was saying, that might not sound a lot, but it can be at these lower weights especially. Just might be feeling the weight in the shot. There's a bit of damage developing under the left eye of Booth. It's not a cut, just a bruise at the moment. And a bit of swelling there, and angriness. Seemed to switch off mentally in that last round, I thought, Booth.
Yeah, he did. The sharpness went. Just started to get caught more. He can't afford to do that. Concentration is the key for Booth. He's got to really keep right on the money. He's got to keep that left hand going in, as it just did very nicely.
It's important for him to win tonight. He had that horrible setback of the attack in the street that left him hospitalized. And some people think that might have just knocked something out of him as a fighter too. I suspect it would have done mentally. It takes a lot of time, I would imagine, to get back properly from something like that. He's a deserving case, I think, Jason Booth. He's represented Britain well and proudly away from home in those European Championship fights. He's the kind of guy who deserves a good break, but he has to earn it.
Not as accurate in this round. Booth can't get the shots on, missing with too many. Just needs to settle down and pick the punches.
Single jabs now from Ntontela, who's on the balls of his feet all of a sudden. That wouldn't seem to be the right kind of strategy for him. I think he has to play the hunter here.
Well, a lot of sparring, not really connecting. Somebody's going to make a little bit more of it. Neither one really knows what they want to do, attack or defend.
Well, Ntontela, I think, is elected here to try to outbox Booth in this round. That's something different.
Nice little sharp shot there, just stung Booth.
Just doing that a little bit more, perhaps, Ntontela.
Yeah, maybe he's got the center of the ring. Maybe just a bit more.
Well, let's see what his brother Nicky's made of it. He's with Ed Robinson.
Well, Nicky, firstly, commiserations for your fight. Gallant effort, but you seem to tire in the later rounds.
Yeah, I'd just like to say before I say anything, you're right, Dad. Sorry, Dad. I love you. I tried my best. Last two rounds, and you know how it goes.
You did try your best. It was a good fight, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a very good fight. It was tough. It was hard. It kept coming. Took a lot more ammo than I thought he could take. He's quite classy, Australian. They are good boxers, aren't they? But like I say, there's a rematch in the making already, so that should happen before Christmas, and you'll see another world champion, just like you'll see my brother in a minute.
How do you think Jason's getting on here?
Jason's getting on easy. He's picking his head off. He's just doing basically, he's sticking to the game plan. He's nicking it. He's being boring and he's nicking it.
You think he'll win on points?
Most definitely.
Thank you, Nicky.
I hope Jason doesn't hear his brother calling him boring.
That wasn't the biggest compliment, was for such a good performance.
And blimey, the other fights only ended about a few minutes ago. They were already talking about a rematch before Christmas. I'm not sure Sting's people are going to agree to that. Unless, of course, the money's good, it might be. Might be better. Ought to be. Seventh round. They seem to make it up as they go along sometimes for these titles.
58-56 on my scorecard. A couple of points ahead for Booth.
But Tontella's won the last two, I think, on your card and mine. So is that significant? We move into the second half of the fight. Jason Booth, blue trunks. Trying to make sure it isn't two defeats out of two for the Booths tonight. Wouldn't have been in the Nottingham script. Just not looking so sharp as it's gone on, Jason Booth.
No, he hasn't built on a good start. He's just gone into his shell a little bit, and Ntontela getting more and more into the fight.
Oh, big left hand! And down goes Jason Booth. Cracking shot. Booth told him it was too, strangely, as he was down there.
Nice, hands up, hands up, hands up.
Put your hands up and walk to me. It was a big shot. He's down. And I think he says good shot to him when he got up.
Well, he was right about that. That was a good shot. And now it's all changed around now.
Nailed him with another left. This isn't looking good now for Booth, because he doesn't look so elusive or fast. He's there in front of Ntontela. And Ntontela obviously does have a bit of a dig, as our South African spies told us. Well, Booth's still talking to him.
Yeah, he's got plenty to say. He wants to concentrate on what he's got to do.
Save your energy, Jason, and concentration.
Gotta be careful, he's walking onto that left hand.
Fights level. And he's talking to him still. It was a two-minute round. That was a two-minute round. Goodness me. Now that's vital, with one fighter having been on the floor in the round as well.
Yeah, isn't it just? And Ntontela camp, they'll be a little bit upset, and rightly so, at that short round.
Well, there was a world heavyweight title fight once in South Africa. One of the rounds went to 3 minutes, 50 seconds.
Yeah, you don't want many of them, do you? That's what you definitely don't want. Well, there it is. Lovely, lovely time shot. He was quickly up, but it was a good shot with the left hand. Just left himself home, ducks underneath, and as he moved his head to the side, the left fist was there. There it is, very well delivered.
And it was an opportune error by the timekeeper for Jason Booth. Not that he looked as if he was about to get knocked out, but he could have done with a short round there, and he got it.
Again, nailed with the left hand. He's unable to get out of the way of this shot. This is causing problems for Booth.
This has swung right back against him over the last three rounds. Jason Booth seems to have lost his speed. Got in with a good left hand of his own, mind you, there. He's going to have to stay out of this guy's way. As you said earlier, he might have to run a marathon or two. But can he do that now? Is he getting slowed down by these body punches?
Well, I think this is the problem. It's a steady pressure. It's not an exciting pressure that he's adopting, Ntontela, but it's just steady pressure. But it's hard to keep on the move and keep away from that.
And he's heavy-handed as well. It's a natural 8-stone-3 fighter against a natural 8-stone fighter. That's something to mix in as well. Just that slight move up in weight is something that would count against Jason Booth as well here.
Good right hand, just steadying Ntontela up with that.
The 10-8 round in the last one for Ntontela leveled it up on the scorecards for both Glenn and I.
And a few nice counters, steady work rates from Ntontela.
He might be raw, but he does have a bit of a dig, and he's getting to Jason Booth, you sense here now.
He's a little bit open when he comes in, Ntontela, can be caught.
Can Booth come up with something different? Can he switch it around again? Can he use his experience to negotiate his way through the 12 rounds and start to pick up points on the cards again? Nicely picked right hand that time from him.
He's landed some nice counters, Booth, in this round. I'm not sure there's been enough of them.
Well, it hasn't been the nightmare that the previous 2 minutes, and it was 2 minutes, turned into. Back at all from Booth in this round.
Yeah, he's built on it, he's kept the counters going. I think he might have stung Ntontela a little bit with that shot.
And again, he rocks back the South African. Little switch, good finish in the last couple of minutes of the round there from Booth. He raises his hands and feels he scored a psychological point as well as a couple of physical ones too. But from a quiet start, this has developed into quite an absorbing argument now, Glenn.
It is. And then this, the punches, 375 thrown. But Booth landing more better punch economy, good percentage there, 39%.
That's high, isn't it?
That's good, sir. But you can tell that with the accuracy. Look, he hasn't wasted many shots. Look, you just see that lovely little left hook there.
39% for people at home who might not see a lot of it. What's a good percentage, do you think, to land? Economy wise,
I think if you're anywhere around, you know, 30, 34, somewhere like that, then you're pretty accurate.
Get out. Yeah, it's not like the GCSEs where you have to get about 75% or whatever it is.
I don't know anything about them.
Not now, anyway. This is the ninth round. There's Jason Booth in the blue trunks. Is this another one that's going to be decided in the late rounds, as the one involving his brother was earlier? He lost Nicky Booth to Nathan Sting. Good right hand, well picked that by Booth.
He's picking his shots well. What I'd like to do is see a bit more work rate from Booth. Put the punches together, combinations. Let's see what this fella's like on the back foot. Take the fight to him a little bit with lots of shots.
This is where Booth's experience could come in handy with those European Championship fights. Just been there a little bit more than Ntontela. There's southpaw for a moment there. Booth back to orthodox again. Just a brief flirtation with the other style.
Doing better in this style, just pressuring Ntontela with the feet. That's making Ntontela lead, and that's when he can counter. He's drawing him into him.
Just wonder whether Tontella's mentally relaxed a bit, having put his man on the floor. I wonder if he thought it was all going to fall into place for him nicely, as it does in his other fights. But Booth's having none of that. He's come back again with something else. Nicely done. Punches and then away. He doesn't want to be standing in front of this fella. Well, that's just a loss of balance by the 21-year-old.
Ntontela looks down at the corner in there. I'm not sure what that was about.
He's just gone into his shell a little since he scored the knockdown. Strangely.
I think Booth come back at him quite well, and you know, he might have stung him with some of these sharp shots that he's thrown. I just want to see him up the work rate some more.
Tried a right hand, which would have knocked Ntontela into the River Trent, I think, if it had landed. Missed by a country mile. Scientist in there at the moment, Jason Booth again, and he's nicked a couple of rounds back. And I think Booth's gone 2 points clear again.
Yep, he has. They were both Booth rounds. That was good boxing. Re-established himself in the fight, and he did that quite well. But yeah, he's still. I like when he just puts the teller on the back foot, mixes it up.
A bit more authority.
The Shinfield team with Jason Booth in the corner. A bit more authority they're asking for from him.
Yeah, when he come back after 3-4 rounds, 5-6, and then that 10-8 round in the 7th to win the last two. So he's done that well. It's a good change in mid-fight. And getting back on top.
Three to go.
See, just one punch there. What you want to see there is two punches. Bring the combinations in, left and then a right.
That's basically what the corner were asking for, I think. So here's round 10. Booth's sweeter boxing against the heavier hitting of the raw South African, Lunga Ntontela. Raw but useful, I'd say.
Well, just 21. We know that Booth is a good quality fighter. So, yeah, you've got to see this kid's doing quite well.
You don't see that many bad fighters, do you, coming over here from South Africa? They've got a pretty tough education, it seems.
Well, I've got the utmost respect for them.
Just the one knockdown, Booth on the floor in round seven. Booth came back with his own good right, and then two more. Good combination punching. There's the two you were looking for, and he gets through again with another two. Then the body shot. Good here from Jason Too Smooth, Booth.
Well, we've been looking for that all through this fight, putting the combinations together. Too many single shots from Booth. Too many just looking for the one-punch counter. Let's see him up the tempo and see what he can do.
And he looks to just lead with the right for a moment, thought about it, it goes back to orthodox. Just looking to confuse Tom Taylor a little. One big punch, his uppercut, he staggered him with that one. Not quite sure what the referee was doing there because he seemed to be hurt, Tom Taylor. Well, that was a kind of mini timeout called by Terry O'Connor. What was that about, Glenn?
Well, I think, you know, he was saying keep them up, but I think Jason Booth didn't react the way he should anyhow. He should have reacted quicker.
He's getting to him now, that right hand. Rocked back the head of the South African. Big stuff here for Booth. And Tom Taylor wanting to hold on. 10th round, different fight again. Booth, who's been on the floor, at this point, looking like the likely winner.
Well, he knows what to do. Ntontela hasn't got the defence for clusters of punches.
I think at times he's beginning to think here, Booth, and he's thinking, well, what's this guy like on the back foot then?
Well, he's had some of his best success when he's just backed him up slightly.
He's just changed strategy slightly.
Keep him up!
Another one just going a bit low there. Touch guns at the end of the round, and it's Booth's round again. He's won three in a row on my card. And I reckon that was his best round yet. Tom Taylor was hurt in that round. Let's see if we can unravel this incident.
Yeah, he's just telling him off for pulling the head down there. He put his hand behind the neck and pulled it down.
Well, he almost couldn't help it because I think he doubled him up with the shot.
Yeah. But you're still not supposed to do that, and he was right, Terry O'Connor, to do that. There's a decent shot there that was, you're not allowed to do that.
Yeah, he kind of pulled him onto the right hand.
Yeah.
So, yeah, the ref's got that right. Looking at that again, Terry O'Connor.
Here we go.
Here comes the 11th. Trunks of the South African Lunga Mad Dog Ntontela, as he calls himself, defending this IBO championship. It's amazing, isn't it, how you can hold a so-called world title when you've only had 10 fights. Oh, he's got, he's rocked him again there. Left hand, his knees buckled, Ntontela. And Booth doesn't really follow it up, not really.
The finishing Booth is not good. He hasn't got that instinct, has he? Too careful. He should have been all over him there.
He really had him hurt. Is Tom Taylor starting to unravel here? It looks like it.
Yep, Too Smooth, a little bit of the too careful.
Too careful, yeah. He was there because he had it going. I don't know, maybe he was worried by getting caught by some kind of sucker punch on the counter by doing that. Now Ntontela, having been given time to recover, whips in his own left hand.
That's what happens, you've got to react. You hurt your man, you've got to be quick.
Seize the day. That was Dead Poets Society, wasn't it?
Carpe diem. What is that, is it?
class. Just fancies that he can toy with Ntontela for a moment. Just backing off now, the South African. Definite switch in the plot strategically as this has gone on. Booth is starting to look the puncher, isn't he, now?
Yeah, well, he's managed to catch Ntontela all through this fight, just not with combinations, single shots, and had his best successes when he's put two or three punches together.
Just looking to almost pickpocket little phases of the round. Booth's experience has been a major factor here. He's come through that little crisis, hasn't he?
You know, I don't think he's really worked hard enough in this fight. You know, maybe that's been a bit too critical, but I think he's made Ntontela look a better fighter than he really is. Because he does look a bit limited, slow of hand and foot, and he's caught him quite well at times, but I think he could have done a lot better job than this. You could have really hit on some of that injury that he had when he was attacked. That could have took some out of him.
What do you think he should have done differently then, Glenn?
I just think he could have worked more instead of, you know, it's been too many single shots. He could have just upped the tempo. A little more devil.
A bit more combination punching.
Yep. I think he's shown too much respect. When, you know, he's been pretty easy to hit. There's the good left hook over the top, and the legs do the funny dance there.
But then he stood off.
Unbelievable. Look at the reaction time was far too slow. And then even then, as he goes forward, ultra careful.
Maybe he believed that Ntontela wasn't really hurt, but it looked for all the world as if he was.
Well, I've gone 4 points ahead. One with 6-1 with two. I think it's pretty similar to you.
Yeah, about that. He thinks he's winning it. 3 minutes to go. Only people that matter are the judges. They touch gloves, final round. Fight that's had its little moments of drama, notably in the seventh, when Booth was down on the seat of his pants. And I must say, at that particular point, he would have got longish odds on him actually getting up to win it.
Booth picked a nice right in there again, single shots.
Just trying to kid Ntontela out of it all the time. Booth, heavier hitting. Certainly in the early phase of the fight, seemed to be coming from the South African, but not so much of it. Oh, he's got him with the right hand there, knees buckled again. Is Ntontela ready to go? Booth looks to be the one now with the extra firepower. When he sets his feet and stands there and throws the combinations, and maybe you're right, Glenn, with a bit more devil, he could have knocked this bloke out.
Yeah, I think he could have gotten the stoppage. There's still time for him to do that, but he just hasn't reacted right.
I think there have been blurred boundaries with the strategies a bit here. I think he thought early on that he had to dance and move, and it did look that way. But all the signals in the later rounds are that he can win the argument close up with this guy. Oh, okay, 1, 2, 3 punches into the head, another one to the body. Booth is the boss now.
Yeah, the combinations have worked so well for him when he's put two or three shots together. That's when he's really looked impressive.
Looks like at least one of the Booths is going to win tonight. Yet again, he has something to say to Ntontela. not exactly been the Gettysburg address, but there's quite a long-running conversation going on. Ntontela goes into a silly little kind of march routine in the middle of the ring, maybe a sign of his frustration. Again, better shots from Booth. Heavy-looking hooks to the head, picking the punches better. It isn't an awful performance, is it?
No, he's done well. Come back from a knockdown.
The bell has gone amid all the klaxons from ringside. We didn't hear it. It's all over. And there's Nicky, who hopes that his brother has restored the family pride tonight. Nicky fought pretty good himself, mind you, even though he lost. Has done enough to win that one. Well, he's in tears of emotion himself. It's quite a lot to deal with, isn't it, emotionally, all in one night, as if in 12 rounds like he had, and then watching his brother.
Yeah, it's a lot. I always found it with my brother that it's harder to watch your family than perform yourself.
Here's the number of punches landed. Booth, a lot more. In fact, nearly 100 more.
Good success rate, 41%. Yes. That shows he was accurate, picking his punches well.
Without banging on about last week, of course, De La Hoya landed nearly 100 more and didn't get the decision. I've got there, on my card anyway, I've got Booth 5 points clear.
Yep, I've got it 5 points clear, 116, 111. And a comfortable winner, which was very, very good after that seventh round, the 10-year round, to come back and win everything from them. That shows, you know, a good deal of confidence and getting your mind together, getting your concentration together.
There are the three men who will score the fight. Well, I say will score the fight. They've already done it, and they've had it in their cards, which are now being collated. And unless there's been a big injustice, Jason Booth has won that fight, I think. I think he won the last five rounds, had it level after seven. Lost his way a bit in the middle of the fight. High level of ability, maybe a bit of devil lacking at times there. He didn't show a lot of clinical finishing touches. But here we go now with the decision. Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we have a split decision. Well, well, well. Judge Pakamaila Jacobs scores the contest 114-113 in favour of Ntontela. Judge Paul Thomas scores the contest 115-112 in favour of Booth. And Judge Mark Streisland scores the contest 110-117 in favour of... And a new... divergence of opinion there. The American judge had it by 7 points to Booth. Paul Thomas had written by 3 points. The South African judge gave it to the South African fighter Ntontela by one. But justice was served. Booth has won the IBO Super Flyweight title, and deserved it was too. No surprise that we had a little frisson of controversy once more. But he's got there. Spencer Oliver, your thoughts on that display?
Well, the display, I thought it was top class and didn't get involved at all. I was amazed at the scoring there, to tell you the truth. Split decision.
No, come on, you weren't amazed by it. You can expect anything in this business.
Well, it was shocking. If they beat Shane Mosley and Oscar De La Hoya was bad, well, the split decision there, come on. I mean, there was only one man that won that contest, and that was Jason Booth, and he won it clearly in my eyes.
Looks as though he's got... time to have a quick word with us. Ed Robinson's waiting to ask the question.
Well, Jason, congratulations. You won it on your pure boxing skill tonight. Was that always the game plan?
It was a game plan for me because I knew it looked dangerous to me. And it proved as when he did land one punch, you know, he hit me once and I was on my arse, so...
He hit you with a left hook in the seventh round. They put you down. Were you hurt?
No, flash knockdown. But my legs were weakening after that, so I had to dance even more. But I didn't put half my power together. If I put some of them hard shots together that I did, he were going, wasn't he?
the last couple of rounds, it looked like you might be able to step it up and stop him. Why didn't you?
Because I didn't want to break it, because I've got a bit of an injury. I'm not going to say what it was. I didn't want to jeopardize that for future fights. So I just done my job, and I was just too smooth tonight, and I'm the new world champ over the year.
How does that feel?
Feels good, ain't sunking yet, but I'm proud of my performance, because I just use my basic skills that's going to win most of my fights.
Well done tonight.
Thanks a lot, man.
It most certainly was a polished display. Spencer, finally from you, what new have we learned about Jason here?
Well, you know, Jason's always had it tough. His three European title chances over abroad. I mean, he's got home advantage here. And what we've learned is that he can do it at international level.
Spencer, thank you very much indeed for being with us here tonight. One other home win here in Nottingham. Jawaid Khalik at welterweight tonight. A points winner over Maxim Nesterenko in their rematch. Now, there'll be highlights of that on Ringside on Thursday night this week. Join us for Ringside, 9 o'clock, Sky Sports 3, as we also look ahead to next weekend on Saturday Fight Night. Our top light welterweight star returns. It's Ricky Hatton against Aldo Rios, live on Saturday Fight Night from 8 next week on Sky Sports 1. And in a fortnight, what a lineup! All this. Evander Holyfield against James Toney in Las Vegas. It's live in a big fight special in a fortnight's time. It all starts at midnight. There's also Eric Morales meeting with Guti Espadas in Los Angeles. That is also live. And before all of that, Brian McGee will top the bill first on Saturday Fight Night in a fortnight's time. And on top of all of that, a little further ahead, Floyd Mayweather's world lightweight title defense against Philip Ndao coming on Saturday, November the 1st to Sky Sports 1. It's live once more. Here in Nottingham, thanks for being with us. Let's hope that Nicky Booth can learn some of the lessons from his big brother. From us all, bye for now.